Okay, ma'am, we can start now.
Okay, fine. Very warm good morning to respected trustees of Vidya Bharati Trust Institution, respected principal Dr. Piyush Jain sir, all department heads, civil department head and co-coordinator of this event, Professor K. Ur Shah sir, organizing committee members, Professor Nikunj Ashiani sir, Professor Yadav sir, all department faculty members and all respected industry delegates, faculty members and student participants. Myself, Dr. Damayanti G. Badga, Associate Professor of Civil Engineering Department, welcome you all on behalf of our S.N. Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, Umra, for DST Gujarat Coast sponsored 2-day national workshop on challenges and opportunities in the research field of civil engineering during 30th and 31st July 2021, organized by Civil Department of our institute. Before giving event introduction, I would like to request our requested principal, Dr. Piyush Jain sir, to give little glimpse of SNPIT and RC Umra.
Thank you, madam. Good morning to all of you. As a principal of this institute, I would like to welcome all the participants of this DST Gujarat Coast sponsored 2-day national workshop on challenges and opportunities in the research field of civil engineering on 30th and 31st July 2021, which is organized by the Civil Engineering Department for academicians and industry persons and coordinated by Dr. Damayanti Badaga and her enthusiastic team of civil department, including head Professor K. Ur Shah, Professor Nikunj Ashiani and Dr. Yajjat Jabbar. For this program, institute is thankful to all dignitaries of DST Gujarat Coast who sanctioned grant for this knowledge sharing activity. I would like to congratulate all the participants for being a part of this national workshop. Vidya Bharati Trust is the name associated with the education for more than 3 decades near Bardoli of Surat district and has now evolved as a symbol of quality education dedicated to nurture the talent and aspirants of the bright youth of our nation. Sri Sitarambhai Narayanji Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, Umrak, located at Sonim village, Baben, one of the premier institutes from vision to reality for the youth of the Gujarat region. S.N. Patel Institute of Technology is a leading technical institution approved by the AICT and affiliated with the GTU and established in 2008 with the intake of 240 in 4 UG programs. Later on, the sanctioned intake by the AICT increased to 540 with the 6 UG programs, as well as it is the PG centers all in the Gujarat, in the Bardoli, which is affiliated to the GTU. In this institute, we still have the 6 UG programs, computer, civil, mechanical, electrical and chemical, as well as the PG programs in mechanical production, civil construction engineering and management. And all these courses are GTU affiliated as well as AICT approved. SNPITRC has emerged as a consistent top ranking institute in the GTU examination from the beginning till now, with 13 university gold medals, with 3 gold medals in 2019 itself, which is one of the greatest achievements in the history of the institute. SNPIT and RC achieved top rank in GTU results in all over state more than 10 times. Recently, in the last examination, institute secured 100% results in the semester 8 examination. As we say that to develop any institute, the basic pillar is the faculty members. They are the strength of any institute. So it is my pleasure to convey, and it is very means the assets of the faculties are always the assets of the institute. So more than 25 members either completed PhD or pursuing the PhD from esteemed institutes such as IIT, NIT or state universities. Our institute has many sophisticated labs, including vertical machining center, NABL accredited material testing lab and environmental audit cell. In addition to that, SNPIT and RC is possessing good infrastructure facilities along with Wi-Fi facilities, including well-established library, good transportation system and girls hostel within the campus. Currently, after a short span of 12 years, the institute is providing quality education with cultural values to the international students all across the global, including Ethiopia, Afghanistan, Uganda, and Nigeria every year since 2017 under the ICCR program of GTU. And as the looking to the credibility of the institute, consistent international students are allocated by the university to this institute. The placement drive conducted at the institute during the last 3 years placed about 238 students at various MNC companies such as Reliance Jio, L&T, Astro Infotech, and many more. Around 765 video lectures in various subjects have been uploaded by the highly qualified faculties of this institute on GTU portal during the pandemic time of the corona. And for that one, 5 faculty members have been awarded as the Corona Warrior Awards, as well as this institute is recognized as the Corona Warrior Institute. MOU is signed between the SNPITRC and CO Elements Ankleshwar, as well as Academic Institute GEC Dahod, to bridge the gap between industry and academics. The institute is recognized as a nodal center for skill development program of government like PKVY and benefited many students for the last 3 years. Recently, one more feather has been attached with the SNPIT. It is also attached now Unnat Bharat Abhiyan and adopted 5 villages for the all around well development of that villages. Many students have received SSIP grant for their project work under UG and PG work. SNPITRC Umrak is a participating institute of many other programs, FDPs, which is regularly conducted by the AICT Gujcost. This institute shines day by day with the rising stars, including students and faculties, by achieving most prestigious award like Devang Mehta IT Award, IST Best Teacher Award, Best Student Award for the 3 consecutive years, 2017-19, and Best BTech Program for the last 3 consecutive years, 2016-18. Also, the institute always works in the direction of harnessing the potential of the students by organizing cultural festivals. This institute organized Zone 5 journal program, which is permitted by the GTU from 2017, 15, 16, 17, and 19. This is the 4 consecutive year this program was conducted by this institute. Technical activities like Technocracy, project fair, job fair, and many other activities, which is either sponsored by any governing bodies, are conducted on regular basis by this institute. Various social activities such as blood donation, tree plantation, and other NSS units are also the part of the events which is conducted by this institute. It is my pleasure to say that NSS award is also awarded by the university to NSS officer Professor Hitesh Taylor, as well as to the institute. One of the webinars includes the involvement of the GTU for live webinar by Param Pujya Gyan Vatsal Swami on sanitization of mind has been conducted last year on 6th June, and it was highly appreciated all over Gujarat. All these key features of the SNPITRC attract students when they have to choose the career and they are aspirant for the UG program. It is real the strength of the institute that more than 700 admissions in various UGN programs are the part of this institute for the last 3 years. So in this premier institute, I welcome you all and conveying my best wishes to Civil Engineering Department Coordinator Dr. Damayanti Badaga, Head Professor Keur Shah, and Organizing Committee members Dr. Yajjat Jabbar and Professor Nikunj Ashiani. I am confident that in these 2 days, this program will get a lot of success. And right now, Dr. C.D. Modera, sir, is with us. Welcome, sir. And I welcome to you, sir, in this event. And I need your blessings to conduct this program in a nice manner. Best wishes to all of you. Thank you very much. And congratulations to Civil Engineering Department. coordinator, head, and the organizing team for such a wonderful event. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for the nice words and also giving glimpse of our institute, our participants, and conveying best wishes for the grand success of this event. Now, I would like to request our department head, Professor Keur Shah, sir, to give a few glimpses about our civil department.
Good morning to one and all present over here. First of all, welcome to all dear participants for the online knowledge sharing gathering for DST Gujco sponsored two-day national workshop on challenges and opportunity in research field of civil engineering, organized by Civil Engineering Department for academician and industry person. The Civil Engineering Department is running Bachelor of Engineering course since 2009, having the current intake of 126 and postgraduate ME in Construction Engineering and Management program since 2012 with 18 seats. The prime goal of department is to bridge the gap between rapidly expanding technology demand with innovation, research based by using skill quality consensus approach to achieve an admirable grip in academic field of civil engineering. The branch imparts a wide range of technical education tracks, starting from fundamentals to advanced methodology of civil engineering field. It offers bright and promising career opportunity and professional advancement. The Department of Civil Engineering ensures that the students have the opportunity to work with latest technology and equipment along with innovative thinking and to get exposed to prevailing civil engineering projects on the field as well as in industries. We wish best of luck for program to get advanced knowledge for various domain of civil engineering. I congratulate and thanks to all event coordinator and faculty member of civil engineering department and obviously all participants, because without your active involvement, this is not possible. Thank you very much to all.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Thank you so much, Keur sir, for such a nice glimpse of department and conveying best wishes. Without your support, guidance and motivation and the principal's active involvement and guidance, this is not possible. So now I will just give to little introduction about the event, that academic always playing an important role for the society. But kind support to academicians in a true manner from various platforms give best output to society through academics, right? So during pandemic, many researchers and industry persons faced many problems in the field of civil engineering in different area. So during common discussion in various civil engineering group, that idea came in mind to organize such event for all, and our respected principal sir, Dr. Piyush Jain sir, agreed upon this idea and guided for DST Gujcost scheme for funding. And finally, Department of Science and Technology Gujcost sponsored our national workshop proposal, and you all respected members' participation from industry and academics make this event possible today. So for this, we are also thankful to DST Gujcost, all the participants from industry academics, Dr. Narottam Sahu sir, Bhumi ma'am, who all supported very nicely. Main objective of this program are to spread awareness about recent trends in the research area of civil engineering, to show the advancement in different sectors of civil engineering field, to provide knowledge regarding opportunities and challenges in various fields of civil engineering in this pandemic. Focal area of our this workshop is overall review of civil engineering field, focusing on various sectors, detailed study on environmental and water resource engineering field, research, opportunities, challenges, explanation on recent advancement in the field of soil and structural engineering too, as well introduction and research opportunities and challenges in the field of smart materials and concrete technology. So all dear participants are requested to please stay connected in all sessions to grab opportunity to strengthen knowledge from experts of different fields. Thanks to all participants, we welcome you all. Now, first speaker between us during our inaugural session, Dr. C.D. Modhera, HG Scale Professor of SVNIT, Sir is my guide, my guru, my mentor of life. So I always start in good academic social work with his advice, guidance, and with his active involvement. And this is my privilege to introduce today's speaker, my guru, Dr. C.D. Modhera, sir, professor from SVNIT Surat. Sir is having very long profile as well. Sir is a Google person, so I will give brief idea about the sir. So I will request Nikun sir. Sir, please display the yes. So you can see that Dr. C.D. Modhera sir has completed his PhD from IIT Bombay in 2001. Sir has completed his MA Civil with the specialization in structure in 1992 from SVRCT Surat, which is right now SVNIT Surat. Sir has completed BE Civil in 1989 from SVRCT Surat only. If we will talk about such achievements and career, so we need more than an hour to explain all the details. So in a brief, sir is a life member of various professional bodies and actively taking in charge of like ICI chapters, IST chapters, II chapters, and many more chapters at Gujarat level, Surat level, and actively involved in various professional bodies. Sir has received many DHT Gujcoast funded research grants for various type of projects. Dr. C.D. Modhera sir guided more than 50 M.Tech and more than 15 PhD students. Sir is having a patent with his guide, Dr. Bairagi sir, on a shear strength, which is a new concept in a civil engineering field. Sir has published more than 100 research papers in various reputed national, international journals, conferences, in India and abroad. So without wasting much time, we will not lose the opportunity to listen our speaker. So now I would like to request Professor Dr. C.D. Modhera sir to kindly start your session. Thank you so much, sir.
So first of all, thank you very much. Thank you very much to organizer of the Institute of Bardoli, and thank you very much due to Gujcoast, they have provided such kind of platform, and participant get update through any speaker. Without wasting time, first of all congratulate and then thanks to the organizer. Name I will not speak, that is again okay, fine. Thank you very much. So far as this two-day workshop is concerned, rightly pointed out, the title is also appropriate, and looking to this this era, how we can go overcome the issue, how can fulfill the requirement or need of this today. Basically objective of, I can say what I understand, say to know about the current situation in construction, shortage of the raw material, then environmental concern also, as well as sustainability is general word everybody are knowing, and the need for some usually alternative materials. Challenge for the future world, we are also witness, it is again taken from some magazine of the construction, by 2050 10 billion people on the planet expected. Among that, 80% of that will live in urban developed environment. Majority live on coastal area, lead to development of massive urban infrastructure. More concrete jungle will be there, so far as urban floods, urban heat, high lands, and sometimes powerful typhoon also there. In spite of that, we have to live in that. Let me do full screen. considerable damage to the life of people, impact on social and environmental condition, and general world. Everybody are knowing in all respect, all engineering, even technology, global warming. So this all region, we are called for achieving sustainability. This is now we have to think for sustainability. And again, we can think if in a, you know, construction is rapid growth is taken place. So exponential construction growth likely to be this. So you think for that how much concrete jungle will be there. So here some thought I have put that basically resolved solution so far as only concrete is concerned, then mainly function is cemented kind of material, not written only cement, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, water, mineral admixture, chemical admixture, and so on. Of course, water by default. Then again, come to the only material side, then high strength concrete, then high volume, other cemented material like GGBS, ultra high performance concrete, self-compacting concrete, sometimes smart dynamic concrete also. Nowadays people are calling mass concrete, roll compacted concrete, pervious concrete. So many actually, but here some few are highlighted. Now what are the challenges in those material or those concrete? Mainly rheology of concrete will be supposed to be understood well, maintained properly. Autogenous shrinkage also one of the challenge. If we are using directly new material, then what could be the shrinkage? Shrinkage and creep is like, you know, what is called time dependent property. So anytime, say due course of time, it will reflect, and that's why whole structure will put in trouble. Internal curing, self-curing, see internal curing we do not know basically. So that also by virtue of, you know, internal CSH gel phenomena introduced, and you know, time to time it create, you know, internal, you can say, bonding and other things, so related to chemistry. So I mean internal curing also sometime is again maintained. Those temperature also is a trouble if you are all in sudden selecting some new material. Self-curing is one of the nowadays people are thinking, because of now water is create problem. I mean very less amount of water immediately available, you can say, reduction of the creep. So creep shrinkage, I told, that is also one challenge. Creep is again not advisable. So reduction we can think by utilizing or by inserting new material. So I think material word itself give very, very, you can say, base for the any structure. Now, if I call, I'm structural engineer, but structure which are made by only material. So material, you are thorough about its behavior, its, you know, principle or its, you know, property in all physical, mechanical, even chemical. Then I think you can be a very excellent structural engineer. So structure become later on by virtue of so many, you know, member, maybe beam column if building is concerned, or otherwise cable or whatever is there. So the thing is that is again it is superstructure and resist by so many, say, wind force, even earthquake shaking and gravity load. So then I think then a structural consultant will be having very good idea about that, where the deflection and, you know, elongation taken place. Accordingly, material has to be introduced, then I think sustainability by default will come. Toughness enhancement, molecular bonding, so this is internal matter. Ductility enhancement, see, ductility is again very, very vast word or very important word so far as any movement or due to earthquake, due to wind, due to cyclone, our structure will get, you know, moved due to that external force. And because of that structure should be ductile. Ductile meaning is that it allowed to, you know, move, and then again it can come back its original position. And I think little bit you can say elongation property should be available. That is the meaning. it can elongate and then come back its original position. So kind of elasticity is one of the involvement great parameter. Shrinkage reduction is also already we talk performance independent of chemistry. Bendable concrete nowadays because of you know we can think we are seeing that about 80% amount of the concrete, but remaining again some other material and then few percentage of the what is called steel, and that is continuous bar. Basically, it is also called as a continuous fiber. So fiber concrete is very very important because of basically concrete. Usually, when deriving any hypothesis, we are selecting or considering various assumption. Practically, assumption is not meeting, and it is not homogeneous but heterogeneous. Everybody are knowing. So concrete is again kind of what I told. It is kind of team of the all three four ingredient, and then again chemical, you know, composition or reaction taken place, and then bonding taken place, and it is become artificial rock. So that's why you can say that it should be produced in such a way that it should be bendable. It should be bendable. Bendable means it is allowed to, you know, some elongation and again like that. So practically people are trying and made it, but sometime cost may be criteria, and practically because brittleness is always involved. Even we are called because concrete, I told that 80% is other material or 80 to 90, only few percentage of the steel is there. So mechanical process also challenge, basically microstructure, tailoring, and I think this is the thing, I think futuristic concrete I told. Background to produce 1 metric ton cement, if we are required to produce 1 metric ton, then it involvement is concerned, basically limestone, 1.5 metric ton is required, it is to be grind. Coal, maybe 0.2 to 0.25 ton, metric ton. Electricity consumption, maybe 70 to 98 units. CO2 emission, again, 0.8 to 1 metric ton. So that's why everybody are knowing that production of the 1 metric ton cement, it will be have 1 metric ton. Practically, it was seen various literature, 0.8 to 1 ton, 0.98 also there. So I mean, this is the range. Now, it means that CO2 emission is not appreciated or not advisable. So one has to think how to reduce it. So that's why alternative SCM kind of material is very much required. Then hazards associated with Portland cement. What are the hazards associated? One is depletion of the natural resources. One thing is limestone, then carbon emission, then water pollution also equally responsible, and Portland cement production of 5% of global CO2 emission. So I think this is similar to first one only. Now sustainability needs. Generally, we are knowing that it should be sustainable, but in all field, basically, if you are talking with respect to environment, with respect to concrete technology, but here it is shown with respect to entire civil engineer or entire, you know, all engineer, I must say. So first of all, you can look at that consume up to 40% of the world energy. When we are looking or preparing this, then 40% consumption will take place. You can go right side, then contribute to 30% of global greenhouse gas emission due to industry. Causes 10% of the world's emission of the fine dust. So remember, say all of a sudden, second aspect, you can observe that it is really danger to the structure, or I mean our RCC structure, or in general, global warming is concerned. But thing is that we cannot stop, because of without that industry, other thing will be not produced. So it is a part of the life only. So among that, we have to find out the some solution or think for that how it can be reduced or how it can be accommodated in our environment. Another 10% of world's emission of the fine dust, that is also there. Dust is there, contribute to the displacement of the most productive land. You can think left hand side, bottom. Then contribute to loss of biodiversity. and you know ecosystem. So this is also a very genuine problem so far as is our industry is concerned. Then last one you can say most widely used material after water. So this is a one very good you can say requirement of the concrete is say next to water means widely we are using RCC or you can say concrete, and that's why you can think that when we are using it should have perform well, it should have good quality of you know it meet the requirement, that is thing, and again it should not create any much problem to the environment. So that is what is people are thinking for that. So here it is mentioned that basically now you also knowing very initial water, we never thought about the water, that water have this much you know value, and we because it was getting very free of cost and it was available you know very good mineral and everything, but nowadays you can say to get good quality of water we have to pay, that's all. So it same thing happen for the concrete also. To perform good concrete, then I think cost will be there. However, it is possible to maintain, it is possible to produce. So many factors are there, only cost may also there, but again so many factors are involved to get good concrete. Sustainability in common sense, what is it? Basically, in my opinion, that sustainability is defined as the meeting the need of the current generation without compromising the ability of the future generation to meet their need. That's all. Again, reading, the meeting the needs of the current generation without compromising the ability of future generation to meet their need, and it is combination of the minimizing environmental impact and economic cost to achieve the required social performance. Sustainable construction is the practice of creating structures and using processes that are environmentally responsible and resource efficient throughout a building's life cycle from siting to design. Okay. And operation, maintenance, renovation, and demolition. Have a check. Are you getting my voice? Because of you sometime respond, because of now in front of me only laptop. Can you hear me? Hello. Otherwise you can call me because of
yes,
now
sir, yes,
you can call without any hesitation.
Sir, we can possibly
listen. It is happening because of my okay, because of we have to work in this era online and with the help of you know power and tower, right? Without power and tower we cannot you know having the communication, right? Fine. So anyway, so here I was talking about the construction, operation, maintenance and renovation and demolition. See, demolition comes, it means that we are thinking to create new modern house or modern industry. So old one supposed to be demolished. So demolition is very easy, but to create, and again that demolition part need to be keep on land, then again land pollution is there. You are throwing in sea, not permitted. So we have to think to utilize that demolition part at certain extent, not 100% possible, but we have to think for that. Principle of sustainable building, for example, structural efficiency. So what is it? To minimize the environmental impact associated with all life cycles, energy efficiency, then water efficiency and material efficiency. These are the four pillars. First, again, what it indicates energy efficiency to reduce the operating energy use, reduce the water consumption and protecting water quality. See, quality again is a sometimes very simple word, but it has great meaning. Material efficiency, material should be renewable. recyclable and environment friendly. So this is to speak, it is very easy, but for that we have to work hard, and then you can think how it can be renewable, how it can be recyclable and reuse, and again it should not hamper to the life of the our lives, you can say. Then it should be environment friendly. Sustainable concrete can be again put in this way, then you can say sustainable concrete, its optimization of material is required, means whatever we are using, it should be optimum. Optimum and maximum have different meaning, as you know. Then second is recycling and waste management. Then improvement and optimization of structure and innovation in material and process. So I think these are the four, namely parameter, which is taken care to produce concrete. And those, if we have taken care at certain extent, at 100% may not be possible, but then that concrete sometime, usually we can say it is become a sustainable concrete, right? So this is the what we have to optimization. Again, I'm telling that everybody are knowing that you use of the maximum powder content, it give good amount of the compressive strength in concrete, but sometimes it's not. We have to again take help of other two material, that is filler material or inert property material aggregates. So both aggregates should have very good quality. However, it can be adjusted in such a way that filler material or this cement powder required minimum. So I think, and again, it should not compromise with the rheology property as well as hardened property. Then it is called as an optimum material. In all three can be optimized, depends on principle of the PPD, particle packing density. So I think it is again very vast things. So I think okay, and then here what is written, improvement and optimization of structures also. So that is also important. Sustainability in concrete making is again further than various ways to implement sustainability in concrete. Ingredient, we are knowing more than 4 or 5, so cement, aggregate, even fine aggregate, second one is called coarse aggregate. Then water, then improved durability. Approach, how cement is concerned, then what could be the, our approach to reduce consumption of the OPC so far as cement is concerned per cubic by replacing with supplementary cemented material, fly ash, even slag and other things can be incorporated. And then I think that the reduction of the cement consumption possible. Aggregate also, basically we are finding or manufacturing from quarries. So here it is suggested that recycle fresh concrete or demolished C&D waste, you can say, can be gathered and try to put in use. In UK, it is there that recycle aggregate, they have to compulsory use 20%. Then and then their project can be executed by concerned authority. So certain bylaws is required. So here in India, it is very much needed. People are using recycle aggregate by their certain extent, but still general bylaws are not existing. Fine aggregate also, because of using the river sand, is again scarcity will be induced, and then we have to think for alternate use of say CCS and slag sand and other thing. Manufacturer sand nowadays people are using. Water, in fact, sometimes we are taking lightly, but very very important. Self-curing concrete is there, then water quantity by default reduce. Use recycled water also suggested, because of industry have the ample or much quantity of wastewater, need to be think recycle and use in industry. High range water reducing admixture also can help to use less use of the water or reduction use of the water. Improved durability, I told, is again very big word, but still we can think how it can be improved. So by doubling the service life of structure bring down half the amount of the material needed for replacement. So you can increase the, you know, service life of the structure, then it is called as a durability. In fact, in our concrete, what we are doing, durability means we are prototype environment exposing, maybe acid effect, salt effect, and so on. And then we are noting its service life, or you can say it's a reduction in strength, reduction in what is called strength as well as weight. We are noting, and then we are again predicting. Again, so many models are, material model is available. You can again link with that, and you can come out with certain prediction kind of equation, and then service of the structure or age of the structure also people are working. So here, that is durability. Again, durable word is very, very, very famous or general. Even layman also use that word. They are going in market and are collecting, or you can say, some goods, electronic good, and by knowingly, unknowingly, they are telling this good is, I mean, this fridge or whatever is there is durable. So durable word is very, very important. It means that it should perform well, and same time, optimum word I can use, optimum cost will be there. Problem with concrete is sustainable material. So concrete is the most widely used material, as we know, and consumes great amount of the resources. That is also we are knowing. Then contemporary concrete typically contains how much in our, you know, that concrete is involved, say 60 to 20% is again concerned with or contains cemented material. 6 to 8% is mixing water, means part of the water or quantity of the water. Then you can have the 60 to 70% of the aggregate. Here both aggregate is taken care. Sometimes 80 also there. It depends on requirement, or you can say very lean mix is there, then definitely amount of the aggregate will be more. Rich mix is there, then little bit reduce and powder content will be increased. Then 2 to 3% admixture by mass if required, then again. So these are the just tentative range has been given, and it is taken from through literature. So I think this just give idea what is the, you know, content of the other ingredients. Why concrete is not sustainable? That if it require basically mining, processing, then transport of the huge quantity of the aggregate, billion of ton of raw material needed for cement manufacturing, utilize considerable energy, and adversely affect the ecology of virgin land. That is by default. Actually, last two is very, very important so far as our global warming is concerned. Ecology word is indicates that it should be balanced in ecosystem. You are always digging and in quarry, and then coming out, you know, taking say even limestone for manufacturing of the cement, and then again taking out some, you know, basalt and other things. So coarse aggregate, even fine aggregate at river bank and other thing, sea shore. So that is again not maintaining balance or equilibrium, and that is nothing but ecology. It hampers at certain extent. Very initial small quantity doesn't matter, but if we are behind that, then definitely it create a very, it can hamper the ecosystem. A large amount of CO2 is produced because of manufacturing of the, you know, concrete. This is the one attached problem, and that's why people are working. And now scenario has been changed also. Very, very long back it was produced by one of the, you know, without cementless concrete, that we will talk later, that is geopolymer. And its drawback was there that it is to be cured at 60 to 80 degree, so that is so in situ concrete sometimes not possible. But you know, precast, very, very, it works. It, in yard it can be manufactured and produce the, and then it is possible to manufacture the that concrete, that we will talk due course of time. So these are the points. This require food processing. I think this is a self-explanatory. However, huge consumption of natural resources has a great impact on environment, is not well controlled. So this is one of the controlling is required. Even you can say certain biology is there, but we people, I mean few, are not, you can say, obeying. And again, we are violating those rules, regulation, and that's why sometimes it is uncontrollable, right? So definitely compromise the ability of future generation to meet their own need, right? That is the points. And the consideration on sustainability of concrete may contain three aspects. See, this is now very, very important. One is how to reduce gas emission and especially CO2 emission, how to reduce energy consumption. In fact, consumption we know, energy we know, but still something should be needed, how to fill that consumption taken place. Otherwise, energy always we are consuming for good cause, but still for certain extent it is need to be, you know, reduce it. That is the things, how to reduce raw material and consumption from natural resources during production, even construction and application of concrete. So this is very, very important. Last, all four, three are very, very important. However, each will have so many, you know, factors and involvement is required. And I think biology again came into picture. So three methods of achieving sustainability of concrete are, we can say, reduce, reuse, and recycle. So these three R is very important. Reduce is very easily can be done. Reuse need to be, more thought need to be put, how it is reusability. And recycle is again more thought is required, how we can recycle and again put, using our mix. Only concrete, this is general, it is applicable to for all material, not only concrete, but as a civil engineer, we have various building materials. It is related to that. So three word is very important: reduce, reuse, and recycle. Disposal has also emerged as problem in India. So disposal, that is now what I told, what is necessity of reusing, even recycling of construction waste. Means India is presently generating construction and demolition waste. Shortly, we are calling C&D waste. To the ton of, you can say, 23.75 million. Okay. So it is roughly 24. And yet, no disposal method is being practiced in 70% of the industry because of easy availability of raw material. See, that is there. By any means, they are getting raw material. So never thought about our C&D waste to be used. So that percentage is very high, 70%. If lacking is there, then definitely industry have to thought how to reuse that waste material. And I am sure that, you know, that aggregate, both aggregate is having, it is inert material. Definitely it will perform again reuse number of times, number of years. So that's why we have to think for to reuse the coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, you know, in plenty form, provided certain bylaws, certain manufacturer, good applicator is also essential, good industry or manufacturer agency also required, and certain bylaws definitely. Due to unlimited use of aggregate, so the extinction of, you know, naturally occurring material will soon take place. That is what we know, and due to this, the application of reusing, recycling, and waste material is favored. So this is again in same aspect, durability word imposed, sustainability word is imposed. So that can be overcome by using, you know, slag based product. Slag is again kind of waste, industry waste material. So it improved the durability and sustainability properties of the concrete having slag based product. Now you are required to, you know, or we have to find out green product maximum use, then it become eco-friendly. Strength, so far as concrete is concerned, namely compressive and flexural strength, support to be good. Chloride ion permeability and chloride mitigation or migration also important. We have to think so far as we wanted to good durability or check the durability. Abrasion resistance, so far as pavement is concerned, or in general also abrasion resistance is very, very important. Carbonation, anyway, carbonation, layman language, if I give example, say you cut any fruit and after some time you are finding its face or surface have different color because of atmospheric effect. And same atmospheric effect existing on outer wall or any structure, maybe beam column surface. So it become different, you know, layer, very micro layer, but that is nothing but carbonation. More deeply, if I can say that if you are having the slice of that concrete specimen and you are sprinkling phenolphthalein, and if color remain unchanged, then that is the portion of the carbonation. If it is having pink color, it means that not affected due to carbonation, and certain depth and width may be measured and it can be modeled. It can be modeled, right? So many model or mathematical model is existing. So one has to think for that. And considering this aspect, durability, it can be give prediction of the carbonation also. Corrosion resistance also important so far as durability is concerned. In fact, resistance word is very appropriate. People are, or industries, few people are, you know, selling their material, say corrosion proof material. So never proof word is again misleading and not proper word. It should be resistance. So corrosion resistance can be taken care by imposing certain corrosion inhibitor. Inhibitor may comes in the form of powder, maybe liquid form, and so on. And how it can be put in on bar for that certain that is called epoxy coating bar, but for that so many drawback is there. So but corrosion inhibitor I am talking about in form of powder or otherwise liquid, it can be put directly while mixing along with water, and then not a big procedure, as good as it is another kind of, you know, admixture, and then you add during time of the, you know, mixing, prepare it and then place properly, then you can say that will work. Sulfate resistance also is one of the parameter to add on durability. Alkali aggregate reaction, I think alkali aggregate reaction also it is a concern with the aggregate. And then alkali means salt is there, and then after due course of time, maybe number of years, that reaction will take place, and then those kind of aggregate is not good for the for it, not properly 100% inert material, means its chemical composition possessing certain chemical, and again due to that other acidic effect or other in salt effect, it will react. So that is also noted, alkali aggregate reaction. So here, see, bottom side, nothing to do with what is called bar, means steel. It is only I am talking about aggregate infected, you can say, due to this. So that's why you can say every, I already told that when we are talking about durability of concrete, means it means that it is not so easy job. First of all, concrete itself have combination of 3-4 ingredients. So that ingredient must meet the requirement of the IS code, and then again if it is meeting, then proper mixing or proper design mix is very essential. Just generally 1:2:4 we are taking, but it is just give guideline. But on site and when you are mixing, there is a chance it may be 1:2.1 is required, or maybe 1.8 is required. So that is the just giving the sake of example. So to don't consider it is very easy job to design the mix, for which you need the practical experience. And it is still, because of in India or all the world, mix design procedure is just giving guideline. You can make the program, that program will not you can say generalize, maybe Excel or maybe any Visual Basic Plus or whatever is there, C++, that will not work. For that, so many data is required, but it is possible to collect, and one has to think, make it generalize, and big program can be done. I mean, computer program, so many parameters, because aggregate itself vary its inherent property region to region, its color, its density, its texture, and so many things are there. And then again, a mixing procedure also vary. Sometimes you can say consider ideal, then no issue. But thing is that few are there which is not in our control. So that's why to make model is again very important. Just so you can proceed. Hello. Okay. Okay, Professor RN Patel. So please start, and I am in one lecture, so kindly adjust accordingly. Now I am okay. So here I was talking about alkali aggregate reaction. Then bio-based product, people are thinking bio-based product, and that product, say what is given in 2 point. First point is written brick made from bacterial byproduct, that which mix cement, sand, particle together in a matrix that strong enough to use or home, and insulation created from agriculture waste product that can grow within a wall. So I think this is just example, but for it is directly told or calling about bacterial concrete. So it is one kind of type of crack, and generally it can be used for the crack filling. So that is there. So this is just looking after how it can be used. Second, another product in work, bacteria infused, or you can say concrete that reportedly fills in hole. So that I told, crack in hole, and making it last longer and reduce maintenance cost. So I think this is again related to bacterial concrete. In fact, it is given just information. Remember, so many things are need to be understand. Each concrete need 1 hour, I must say. Once you are very thorough, then second, why newer concrete came in picture? One is, you can say, fascinate with steel, that is there. Strain hardening desirable, that is one of the factor or proper things. Structural oblique architectural challenging. And then we have to think how new concrete is required. Commercial need also there to cater. And in commercial need means they need only low cost kind of material or concrete, so they will have very good margin and they can save the overall cost of project. That is one thing. To cater to new technology, repair and rehabilitation and retrofitting. So I think this is the 3R again came, and it is very, very nowadays very much required, because of repair is again nothing but simple cosmetic kind of thing. Small crack is there, you can fill it and keep as it is. Rehabilitation, it means that you are just rehabilitating, you know, those structural component, and you are just giving again repairing something, may be added, and retrofitting kind of thing. So not retrofitting, but you can say something you are giving good amount of the external material, and then it can be strengthened through rehabilitation. Retrofitting itself, it is nothing but you are now your structure don't want to say demolish, but you want to get good performance. It need to be added. So for which you can have the extra jacketing or some additional rent, what is called reinforcement, plus additional even member may be added. So retrofitting is again kind of those things. So I think these are the newer concretes, and I mean this is the, because of this new concrete came into picture. Ecological concern, sustainable development, and above all is dynamic of evolution. See, all if you are in connecting, then you can say it is kind of little evolution in concrete taken place. What is evolution in concrete? Technology is concerned, main evolution and other phases. Just I try to, you know, just made the one slide in such a way that you can have the little idea about the what I wanted to say. One is generally called as a control or normal strength concrete. Usual, sometimes it is called standard concrete. I think you refer the IS 456, then certain up to M80, 60, it is referred as a standard concrete, and then beyond that they are calling high strength concrete. Then high performance concrete is again one additional word, and ultra high performance concrete. Even it is written geopolymer concrete also. So these are the some which were not there in, you know, a few decades back. And now it is we are doing. So that's why it is called as a little evolution. But other phases is concerned, even in addition to this, high density concrete, low density concrete, high early strength concrete, high volume fly ash concrete, self-compacting concrete, and, you know, this is called ductile. It is ductile is written ductile concrete. Okay. So I think this was the giving the just kind of the view about the how it can be. You can say you incorporate those things. Some varieties of concrete. Now what is it? Temperature control concrete also very, very important. Specially designed by the lowering the placing temperature with careful proportioning of the binder. The binder is again nothing but our cement constitution, and cooling the ingredient, that is one thing. Ideal for mass concreting, enhancing durability of structure. What are the benefit? So if you are controlling temperature in such a way that it will give the benefits, it will have advantage in no rapid loss of slump taken place, drying of concrete also, then no early setting and stiffening of the concrete, reduced plastic shrinkage and ease for finishing. Because of this shrinkage word itself, time dependent property, I know very initial this is to be happen, that is plastic shrinkage, it should be minimum, it's not big big thing, but still if it is minimum, it is very good. No loss of compressive strength at 28 days. So these are the basic varieties of the concrete, or can, due to control temperature, this can be benefited. Ultra high performance, only 2 minute I am keeping pause, please. 2 minute.
ओके सर, ओके। Dear participants, please wait for a 2 minutes. That is taking pause, and again, sir will start. Dear participant, sir has taken 2 minute pause, so please be with us. Thank you.
So I am available. Thank you. I was talking about the this is one more parameter or very special concrete. Sometimes it's called ultra high performance concrete. Remember, concrete is general word. We know that it is having the different ingredient combination, and it will have different properties compared to traditional concrete. But performance itself indicates it is also high strength, but performance, it is connection with having the ability of the or resistance against the any chemical attack, right, and any other things. So that is performance. So high, again high, and again ultra high means that is high strength ductile material formulated by combining Portland cement, silica fume, quartz floor, then fine silica sand, means fine aggregate, high range water reducer, water and steel or organic fiber. See, remember here fiber also included to. So if it is there, then you can have, this is sometimes it is called reactive powder concrete. Ultra high performance means reactive powder concrete, where only sand, silica sand is there. You know, coarse aggregate we are not finding. High compressive strength will be there if we are talking about powder content, powder concrete or reactive powder concrete, RPC. Synonyms is ultra high performance. People have worked. How to produce it? So that is again in first sentence it is written, which is again contain is Portland cement, silica fume, quartz floor means okay, then fine silica sand and high range water reducer, that different component, that is plasticizer and other thing, okay. And sometime you can, we can use steel, otherwise some organic fiber to produce this. So I think specifically it is beyond or below the 10 mm everything, right? So it is kind of, you know, very very paste kind of thing is there. So here reactive powder concrete will have basically high compressive strength, ductility in post cracking stage, then internal crack bridging capability. Further, we also understand the dimensional compatibility. It must have, again, it should not happen. I told there are, you know, two things are there known as shrinkage and creep, which are the time dependent property. So later on dimension should be stable. Because of these two parameters exist, then you can say dimension get changed. So that is not good, and which directly hamper overall structure. is that our material may involve in column, beam, or anything, chimney, or NDCT, right? So that time also cooling tower I am talking. So then again it is not good. And then essentially zero permeability. Basically it is again permeability again lead or talk with reference to durability. So permeability should be zero. Excellent bonding capability. Excellent bonding capability. So I think these are the thing which is pertaining to reactive powder concrete if we are using. But let me clear, it is totally powder content maximum. So later on issues arises about its durability, right? Here we have very good of advantage. Same time, and again it is three, four times higher cost than routine traditional concrete. So I think when any important structure is there, and then people have to think for that, where cost may not be much criteria, and then go for the RPC. Yeah. I'm just delivering one lecture at STTP. If you. No, you go ahead. Don't. By default, permission is there. Conference, STTP, or special lecture. And now, next month, we will organize one ICI student chapter.
Okay.
You people are required. You may be become a coordinator. So it is in pipeline. Only we are waiting for offline. UltraTech is
challenge.
12:30. So sorry, I was just discussion with my colleague, and now in same aspect further, if I talk, then it has range of formulation which may be used may many different architectural and structural applications. So because of here it is below 10 mm all ingredient or lesser than that, so it is kind of powder, very 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 kind of paste kind of thing. So it is very easy to pump, very easy to form, you can say any kind of thing. Even our concrete also moldable, no issue. But which is purchasing 20 mm or more than that coarse aggregate and other binder material quantity is less, then it creates some time that you will have some other literature. ITZ kind of thing, interfacial transition zone, become very weak in case of the those or standard or you can say nominal kind of is concrete mix. But here it is not happening because of it is altogether everywhere powder content is there, quantity is high, so reinforced with high carbon metallic fiber. See again, make it ductile, what we are see, what is the role of fiber never increase much about the compressive strength, but it is definitely helps to increase the tensile and flexural strength, right? Flexural also nothing but indirect tensile strength. And for which we have, that's why fiber is using. Many are calling, I have used this fiber, no issue. And they are quoting my compressive strength of that mix become 40% above. That is not true because of fiber, you have to apply more compaction. And because of compaction, voids will be reduced. And CSH gel phenomena will be react. Much real, and then I think strength you, by default that you can get it more, but in literature it has been seen 17 to 20%. Okay, see here it is like that. So fiber never play a role to increase the compressive strength. Little it can increase, but tensile strength may be more than 50% or sometimes 100%. So I think that is the literature is available, and it is true because of what is the role of fiber? Just like I think honey, you have seen honey mess, and it can be every place it reach. What is I wanted to say? And when any jerk or any load effect is there, external load, then it try to arrest the you know crack. The crack is there, but because of presence of the fiber, maybe steel or any polyvinyl, then again it helps. That is the meaning. So that's why in reactive powder concrete, of course, inclusion of the fiber, it hampers the workability. That is true, but nowadays available very good chemical admixture, it can be, you know, overcome that issue. That is there, and little initial cost also. That's why initial cost always higher. So reinforced with high carbon metallic fiber, structural UHPC, U stand for ultra, can achieve say 150 to say here up to 200 MPa, and flexural strength up to 20 MPa. So it is like our M20 grade is there. So for that flexural strength M20 itself, so, and then 20, 30, 60 we are talking, 80 we are talking, but 200 MPa compressive strength we can have. And for architectural UHPC application, the inclusion of fiber are also used. So this is the sum where I have taken that is again indicates those element or those structure made by UHPC. Self-cleaning concrete is one of the new era. Basically, cleaning is again what is mean by that. Let me read. Self-cleaning concrete or photocatalytic concrete may sound futuristic, but it's already being used in part of Japan, Europe. So in fact, foreign they have used, and self-cleaning concrete works by adding catalyst and usually titanium dioxide preferred to crisp concrete mix. And titanium dioxide activate in the hardened concrete when exposed to the sun. The activation changes titanium dioxide electric charges and causes repelling effect between the concrete and the dirt and even pollutant on concrete surface. So I think our Ultratech have also done in this hydrophobic kind of, you know, cement they produce, that is work with only water immediately drained. It will not rest on surface of the concrete or structural member if we have used that cement. And here it is same thing, but little having the some external titanium dioxide need to be added and as a catalyst, and then prepare the mix. In fact, this is general sentence. To use it, so many guidelines must be there. Proportion must be there. Proportion mixing technique also having the mixing technique also need to be take care. Self-cleaning concrete is concerned. It is used in construction of the bridge structure, maintain its visually pleasant appearance. Okay, so I think this is just give thought. I mean, or it is existing in abroad. So even India also there somewhere, but that is on experiment basis, not widely we are using. Only everywhere in India, you know, cost come into picture, but still very good structure is there, then cost we are not considering. Very monument is there, statue of unity is there, or I mean that cost is there, but you can say it is taken care all aspect and very good material they have used, because of in that case, you know, it is our prestigious structures, or otherwise you can say durability by default has to be maintained, and rough and tough kind of use will be there. So that's why that time cost may not be considered. And here we are talking about self-cleaning concrete. So concrete sidewalks, then tilt up concrete panel kind of thing can be introduced. This is again kind of transparent concrete people are talking, and this is again taken from even I think Ultratech or otherwise Ambuja have made those things. You know, this block are made by mixing glass fiber basically. So acrylic rod or optimal fiber to make concrete allow light to pass through partially. So I think this is again just decoration or some point of view. It's okay. It is not very good structural kind of behavior, but still it is to be, it is considered as a application. So this is that. sensitive and communicating concrete. So I think this is also one of the way where we have, with the help of physics people and even chemical people, it is possible to, you know, manufacture. So this is the one of the project by Chris Glaister, and you know, I think name are there, and at the RCA Innovation in London. Yeah, it is a place of London. Use heating element and link to allow graphic word and number to be displayed within concrete. So I think this is one of the so I think it is again made at that place. No issue, we can, it is good things. So somewhere when it is required, we can think. So thermo, you know, chronic link, ink is, you know, mixed with the concrete. So ink is there. Use heating element and ink to allow graphics. So here it is like that. So then nickel chromium wire, which heat up when electric current is passed through them, are set beneath the concrete surface. And the concrete thus changing color when certain temperature is reached. So I think it is again very purely on, you know, photoelasticity or kind of, you know, light principle and material, we have to think for that. And it is very much, you know, principle should be known. But this is just sake of information, even detail its chemical composition and other physical property is again missing from my side. I do not know, I know little this, these are the new things. Textile reinforced concrete is again nowadays people are shouting, and use of the textile waste can be incorporated. So it is, what is it basically? A composite construction material consisting of a finely grained cement based concrete mix and high performance and continuous, you know, multi filament yarns made of alkali resistance ER glass. I think glass, E-glass and ER glass, ER means alkali resistance glass, carbon or polymer fiber. So I think when glass fiber is concerned, its own property, glass fiber is very, very good in kind of the, you know, our concrete is concerned, glass fiber reinforced concrete. ER glass also there, this is written, E-glass also there, ER is in practice much. Just so high tensile strength and quasi ductile behavior. Just so you are 56, fine. So this I was talking about the, you know, which is having high tensile strength and quasi ductile behavior, not fully, but quasi ductile behavior, having little brittleness also, you know, by virtue of glass. The TRC composite tend to be slender, lightweight, capable of being designed into complex geometrical shape and configurations. Textile reinforcement is again, you can see, I told that is again happen to be a reinforcement. What is it? Tensile reinforced concrete produces structures that are thin and malleable in nature, you can say. And they have the ability to retain the high tensile strength of the concrete. Further, they have high tensile strength and modulus of elasticity of higher than the concrete matrix surrounding. Basically, when you are using the textile kind of thing, then it is happen to be a non-corrosive nature of fiber material. It is a nature, you know, non-corrosive. So that is biggest thing. Even it works in chloride or high alkali environment. Light transmitting concrete, I have shown. I think it is, this PPT came over here, but it is again more thing is written. Leucon is the new breed of light transmitting concrete. Unlike other version that use acrylic rod or optical fibers, Leucon is made of translucent fabric caste layer by layer into the fine grained concrete in prefabricated mold. So I think it is again long sentence, but basically it possessing acrylic rods or fibers. The result is collection of the fluid, organic line captured within a sturdy panel. And since the proportion of the synthetic fiber to concrete is relatively low, and because the fiber have small diameter, Lucan has the same strength and durability as conventional concrete. The virtually lossless light conduction allows light, shadow, and color to project through the concrete without loss of quality. So I think this is not just sake of information. We are very much interested maximum use of the concrete in general. So here high strength concrete and high performance concrete is written something like as per Japan society. So what is it? Basically high strength and performance concrete with compressive strength, with range I told 65 to 100 MPa. And that is the again as per even IS also, new IS code has included. One very good thing is that IS 10262 2019 has given separate section of special concrete. At least guideline we are getting. Of course, it has been derived based on foreign code, ACA committee importance, even others code has been considered as a reference. So here strength is basically predominantly decided by the compressive strength at 28 days. In fact, in ACI matter or with reference to ACI, they are taking 5 cubes average strength at 28 days. We are taking 3 in India, and that is what I wanted to say. Then performance is governed by the other specific mechanical and durability parameter of the concrete. So when performance word is concerned, it is again, that's why it is written that parameter, durability parameter of concrete need to be concerned. So I told durability is nothing but resistance against the any chemical effect of the structure or concrete. What define the concrete performance? Still it is written, is it just with achieving high compressive strength? Yes and no. So is it greatly explored and established that conventional concrete is an inherently durable and material and its performance improves with increasing in compressive strength? But in case of HSC, means high strength concrete, the performance is decided by each and every material component that is used in making it. So I think it is generally written. Concrete means high strength, means strength is concerned with strength at 28 days, but high performance word is concerned, again, whatever is there, but it will have high strength, but same time it perform well during any uncertainty, any environmental effect, exposure, maybe suddenly rise in temperature, suddenly, down temperature or reducing temperature or otherwise any other environmental effect or other. Second is again acidic effect or any alkali effect, it should perform well. That is the physical meaning. And then so many things are there. Temperature is governing. Let me, and then again I told very initially permeability. Permeability should be zero. Why HSC HPC is required? So basically nowadays changing construction practice, people are now happy to use or work with HSC and HPC. Challenging situation for concrete. Concrete is again challenge, and faster production everywhere required. Durability under service condition, severe condition, durability because of we don't have land. So usually seashore industry have space and people don't want to go, but we would like to construct and use those space for the construction, then of course soil investigation is very essential. However, everything is done, but then superstructure, that is RCC suppose, then it is considered severe condition for design, and material should be sustained. Now sustain what I am using, that should be sustained and it should perform well because it directly put in that environment. So that's why that time cost may not definitely higher than, you know, other region. So that is what, and then it should perform well. Longer service life is again related with durability only, and then maintenance never free from, but at least for few year it should not have major maintenance is required. You can look at exploitation of concrete infrastructure with unexpected load, variation, natural calamities. So I think this is not in our hand, but this is the happening if a particular joint is again predominant, and I mean effect always happen to be a joint. In the shaking take place, then that joint will again affect very tremendously, and it will have the, so that's why this natural calamity also play key role. Then our materials should be sustainable. That is the meaning. High strength is there, then what are the, you can say, benefit? Then resist high working load that cannot be resist by conventional concrete, but natural, because its basic property, that is compressive strength itself, are very high. Increased strength per unit weight and unit volume, that is also there. Flowable concrete due to more symmetric space. Here I told we are not using, suppose HPC is concerned or reactive powder is concerned, then not more than 10 mm coarse aggregate we are using, right? So it is kind of, you know, become like halwa, cement. I mean that mix kind of things. So it is flowable. It is a flowable. And that flowable concrete is again easy to pour in our respective place of the structure. The placing is very easy, that is I wanted to say. And because of placing proper, and because of you were used the very good kind of, you know, water reducer and even plasticizer, even sometimes VMA also there, then it will reach small scale, you can say, amount of the vibration. If it is not SCC, but as good as just SCC, and with a small vibration, it will reach all occupy the spaces and places which we minimize the, you know, voids, and that's why it will consider ductile concrete. It will have minimum voids. That is why good density will achieve, proper bonding between cement and this matrix, you can say, and matrix and bar is there. It will be very good. Better particulate packing, what I told, PPD, particle packing density will be higher, and higher impermeability, remember, not permeability. So permeability is zero, and then that's why it is having the greater durability. Size reduction in final concrete element with reduced dependency on steel for reinforcement. So I think size reduction is there basically, because of even say here we are using 300 or 450, but here if you are having less but same resistance, you can get it, or carrying capacity you will get it. So that's why, so functional space you will get more. That is the physical meaning. Ingredients for HCC, what are to be taken? Now here I told HSC, not HPC. HPC or RPC is little different than HCC. Here aggregate are supposed to be used, and water, mineral, other thing is narrated. Sometimes nano additives nowadays we are using, cement by default. Nano additives, ultra fine additives, means reactive inert with particle size in range of micron to nano level, are found to be useful in enhancing performance of HSC. Nano silica, the most explored admixture, is found to result in high early strength with greater pozzolanic activity. Ultra fine carbon additives such as graphene oxide has shown promising enhancement in HSC performance. Remember, this is again kind of powder additives, right? And it is very fine. And so while put in our mix, it is a very good way react and reaction, and that CSH gel phenomena will be very in greater manner. And because of that, you can have very good bonding ability. And you can say, if you have used this one, carbon additives in mix, then your strength will be having more and kind of very good kind of, even it is artificial rock, but as good as become natural rocks. Nanofibers such as this CNTs are capable, the carbon nanotubes are capable of arresting micro cracks. People are working and even frequently use also. Only when nano word is there or any other additives we are talking, definitely it add more cost. So cost, if you are making cost effective, so sometime very good performance you can't get, right? So that's why sometime important structure is there where cost may not be that much criteria, and at that time it can be used. But still, if durability is concerned and you are again work out that way performance, say X structure is performing 30 years and Y is having certain, you know, additives and it performing 60 years. So you convert that way, then it become cheaper or not that much costly. So I think mindset has to be changed. And now one word I have spoken, mindset. Let me give the example. When I was, you know, very young boy, and that time foreigner come to, you know, India, coming to India, and then they were carrying such kind of bottle in their hand, and we were laughing. We never noticed that why this boy or girl, foreigner is hanging the bottle or keeping bottle in their hand. We do not know. Mindset was not there. Even that time, quality of water was not problem. But now you can say it is our mindset has been changed. We also happy to, you know, use those bottle, and quality conscious, become quality conscious. So same thing, quality consciousness is required in construction industry. They have to frequently or plenty use of the, you know, chemical admixture as well as fiber and other additives. Then I think our structure become, then HPC will be there. Otherwise in laboratory it is become very good, but in field the people have to change the mindset, and then I think HPC will perform well. Now one more thing is there, or type of concrete, is geopolymer. What is it? Activation of natural material, clay actually. So geo is nothing but available in earth crust, and polymerization relate with polymer, so cementing material. So low carbon food, it is a, you know, silicon, alkali and potassium. So I think this is just visualization. This picture is give the idea of what is geopolymer. Further, if we talk, then same source as cement composite and composites, changing ingredients from cement to aluminosilicate. Example of aluminosilicate is, one thing is fly ash. See, you can't find cement. Fly ash, GGBS, silica fume, metakaolin, and rice husk ash, sometimes red mud, locally available if material. So I think this is supposed to be put in mix while preparing the mix of those concrete, and this become a geopolymer. But why geopolymer concrete is required? Well, since beginning we talk about the global warming and CO2 emission and everything. So here we have to think to reduce the CO2 emission, or not use OPC at all, then that is one thing, that is one alternate. Second alternate, utilize waste material from industry, such as in place of cement means fly ash, silica fume, GGBS, ground granulated blast furnace slag, GGBS. Protect water bodies from contamination due to fly ash disposal. These are the just reply for why, and then conserve acre of land that would have been used for all combustion product disposal, and then produce a more durable infrastructure. So these are the supporting reply why geopolymer is required. Geopolymer concrete, you can say, is promising construction material due to its low carbon dioxide emission. That is one thing. High early strength and low creep and shrinkage, acid resistance, fire resistance make it better in usage than OPC. Widespread application in precast industry due to its high production in short duration, remember. And then less breakage during the transportation. The precast also equally important, right? Widest trade application in precast, but in geopolymer is concerned, it will give the high production in within short duration. It not require 28 days this thing curing in water. It is air curing only. And but I will give the problem is only very initial air curing or thermal curing is required, and temperature wise 60 to 80 degree. Second, 3D concrete printing also one of the way where we can talk, I think. Let me check how many remains. So we are still 44. Anyway, it is not issue. 3D concrete printing people are talking. This is because of new things, title, with reference to title, I thought this is to be again included. So what is it? Concrete printing sound like something from realm of science fiction, but it's very much today's innovation rather than tomorrow's world. A research group at Lüneburg University, led by Dr. Sungwoo Lim, has developed a 3D printer, and that is able to build physical object directly from computer generated instruction. So I think just like we are knowing CNC machine in mechanical side, and we can cut or we can prepare shape as per our need. Same thing here also, to computer it can be monitor and the education done. Known as additive manufactured concrete printing is one such example whereby a specific type of concrete which has been developed for the process is deposited in layer very precisely under computer control. Why to print concrete? So I think design freedom is there, you can see, and then sustainability also one of the issue, and for the 3D printing will work. 3D printing technology, big scope for sustainable construction. I think this is just shouting, still somebody has to check it, but it is proven, or through literature it has been seen that such kind of shape can be formed. Drones are one of the new trend in concrete technology. Its usage is increasing on construction side, and we can expect usage of the increase exponentially. Primarily drone survey and inspect site from any aerial view that the contractor cannot. Drone finish inspection in fraction of the time it would take traditionally, although some construction companies were reluctant to use drone. The outcome have benefit them immensely. For concrete professional, drones are beneficial because they can help optimize layout through digitization, and drones ensure that projects stay on track with the ability of increased visibility to spot potential problem. So I think this is here it is like that. This just now visualize. In 2019, Spanish architecture firm used drone to spray cement like substance front of fabric to, you know, construct lightweight structure. See, drone eliminate expensive construction equipment and, you know, speed up the process, and it only took them 5 days to build the prototype, or traditionally it might have taken them weeks. The prototype included a, you know, quadcopter drone to spray shotcrete on fabric. For effective application of shotcrete, you typically need human operator and crane, but with this method you maneuver a drone to do the work, means overcome that issue. Man is not required. I think this is what is it. I don't know. Yeah. Is it because of you were asked, or I don't know. But thing is that the impact of COVID-19 on concrete industry is COVID-19 outbreak has slowed, you know, construction in many countries. The industry has been lower demand for its product, leading to overcapacity. Second, cement companies are, you know, largely expected to survive the crisis, but they must strengthen their sustainability and competitiveness. Companies must also reduce their carbon emission for their long-term viability, with the cement sector generating 7-8% of the global greenhouse gas emission. Pressure is growing for the industry to achieve carbon, you know, neutrality. So this is related to impact on concrete industry. The pandemic full effect on the sector is currently difficult to predict, because the long-term impact of the outbreak on global economy. Are becoming cleaner. Effect on demand. In 2020-2021, global cement demand is expected to shrink 3%. Overall, the pandemic impact will be unevenly distributed, with some countries are more resilient than others. New term for future engineer, I think it is related to topic that you can say carbon credits, that is one, then green rating, embodied energy, then life cycle assessment, sustainability, resilience. Need to understand the meaning of the terms, and this should not just be a, you know, buzzword. So I think if we heard or digest or understand properly, then this is the new term, or I think then we can have the good development so far as construction industry is concerned. New concepts should take the place of the old, you can say rheology instead of the workability, yield stress, not slump, blended cement instead of OPC. Blended cement now we can, because of now OPC, in fact we had used many years, now it should be available blended cement, some kind of thing. Durability instead of strength, because of M20, M30 we are calling, but now something, think about durability. That then material characterization and scientific assessment, not just testing. It's because of people are, we are very happy to, you know, find out its physical property, strength only, sometimes dimension stability, that's all. But we never thought it's water absorption and microstructure. Basically, microstructure study is again need to be understood. Long-term performance instead of 28 days, because we are only make the bench level, is datum line is 28 days, but again, it is to be performed or tested at longer duration, maybe 365 days. Only way batching, no volume batching. Volume batching is, you can say nowadays, is very practically using. So, yeah, but in IS code, we are again making with weight only, and then it can be converted into volume. So instead of that, directly weight batching is suggested. performance to be specified instead of prescribing. Why it is required volume to weight? Because job it automatically take place density. Otherwise, to convert from weight to again volume, then we should be sure that what is composite density, right? So I think so practical issues will be there, but still air content also there. Performance to be specified instead of the prescribing material and mixes. Engineer the structure rather than just build it. I think this is what one thing actually still I want to spare 5 minutes that geopolymer actually people are talking. Suppose this is one of the research area where I wanted to use as a geopolymer, fine, but again geopolymer material I have been mentioned, so that same material I think here it is shown that development of nano enhancement feldspar powder is there, geopolymer concrete for highway construction. Now we are usually talking about the, you know, building, but suppose if it is used for the case of the highway means pavement side, then again it will be a good contribution. So here what is indicated, geopolymer means it is long lasting, low carbon emission because of cement at all we are not using, or otherwise other eco-friendly kind of material we are involved, reuse of industrial waste I already told. So here just earlier I given, but this PPT should be that place it is, since below that, so again kindly bear with, again I am talking about geopolymer concrete. So research if I am introducing, then type of research process, methodology is again very interesting, method of literature survey. See, when we are talking about literature, sorry, when we are talking about any research, then supporting argument or supporting documentation is very much required. Don't follow the some hodgepodge journal. It should be very good. Have standard ACI, ASC, Japan Society of Civil Engineer, Canadian Society. So many journal which is having very good impact factor, or otherwise very, very thoroughly you can say reviewed. That's all. Otherwise, so many journal are there. You pay 1500, 2000, your things will be published. But it is not to internationally renowned journal or literature survey is required, and again for that method is supposed to be, you know, fixed design of experiment. See, all in sudden don't start experiment, you have to design first, you have to think that, otherwise you have started not tested pilot test and you started your huge amount of the experiment work, then sometime it is wasting time and money and energy. So that's why we have to design our experiment in such a way that which we cater our need, which will fulfill our requirement. Data sampling, various statistical method of data validation. And so first, this kind of thing is very much required. Aspect of technical presentation and research article writing. This is again, you attend such kind of workshops, such kind of seminar, conference, and then you develop the, you know, your habit to writing article in, you know, particular paper or the seminar. Intellectual property rights supposed to be understood very well, and patent registration method. So I think these are just in research, and the advantage meaning convey the advanced concrete technology that is also given in this production process, composition and classification of cement. This is one things should be understood in advanced concrete technology, cement chemistry, heat of hydration, various type of chemical and mineral admixture, what is effect on performance of concrete, advanced method for mix proportion based on particle, you know, density, rheology of concrete is should be understood, failure of concrete should be understood, creep and shrinkage of concrete which is time dependent of property, and durability issues is concerned, then various type of chemical attack, EAR, alkali aggregate reaction, corrosion of bar, etc. So many are there, here listed 3-4, and tests for the measurement of durability. So I think this should be understood. over your research so far as geopolymer is concerned, in India, amount of construction has rapidly increased since last two decades. Most engineer construction are not eco-friendly. Construction industry use Portland cement, which is known as to be heavy contributor, known to be a heavy contributor. So construction pollution is concerned. Look at that CO2 emission 2.6 billion ton from oil and gas, and which is pink color, it is 3.3 from building. Again, one more steel and cement. So you put together 3.3 plus 4.6, so 7.9 billion ton from our things. However, it is again coal and gas also generation CO2 13.5, and again others are there, then it is 9.2, like that. So this is I have taken from International Energy Agency, which is published. And even you read in Economic Times that our Union Minister Nitin Gadkari also insisted on where to reduce use of cement, steel in road construction. So that's why geopolymer is very if you are using in rigid pavement, it will be very great area, very good contribution, right? So use of the supplementary cementous material like silica fumes, fly ash, GGBS, that is again repeating, that sugarcane, bagasse ash also there, along with Portland cement, maybe one of the possible, 100% may not be possible, but certain percentage you can incorporate after making refinement, not directly raw material. Raw material sometimes not work well, so sometimes it is required to, you can make proper. The use of SCM with Portland cement can be very limited due to performance issue. So that is all and sudden. Otherwise, it is hamper the overall property of the cement, property of the concrete. Geopolymer concrete is the possible alternate solution, I told. Then the technically geopolymer concrete is manufactured without Portland cement. It consists aluminosilicate material like fly ash, slag, etc., and alkaline activity like NaOH, Na2SO4, and sodium sulfate, and this sodium hydroxide. Geopolymer concrete have double folded advantage. What is it? Lesser carbon emission and incorporation of the industry waste, because of we are again accepting their industry waste, and so that's why we are calling byproduct. As per the research, the CO2 footprint geopolymer concrete can be approximately 9% less than the, compared to concrete containing 100% OPC binder. Again, more thing if we see, then what is geopolymer concrete, that I will not explain, but still read. What is it? Natural-like material, metakaolin, or industry byproduct like fly ash or slag are source of the silicon, Si. Aluminium, Al. So these silicon and aluminium is dissolved in alkaline activating solution and subsequently polymerized into molecular chain. You can see this is a chemistry manner it is written, and become the binder. So this binder are required size mix with this concrete material can be performed here. So I think here little things are not written properly, but the thing is that what is geopolymer? So it is a combination of silicon, alloy, and with the help of activator, we can prepare those things. And again, GGBS and fly ash we have taken. Again, more clear ingredient is concerned, aluminosilicate source with that, alkaline solution is required in aggregate, and then geopolymer can be induced or manufactured. So, property of geopolymer is again narrated over here, higher mechanical property, that I think this we have discussed earlier, mixed design of geopolymer, so no standard method is available for mixed proportioning, various method and literature for geopolymer, some of which are listed below, means target strength method, performance based method, statistical factorial model method, and particle density method. But among that, first one is very easy. We can concern or take similar line of the IS 20102622019. So here, just tentative, I have given the state of art for geopolymer concrete. If you want to design it, then selection of parameter, which type of binder you are considering, type of alkylate activator and their proportion. Because every binder have own property, every this activator have own property, then its ratio need to be decided based on literature, and then if you are taking that guideline, then and then your things will be good. Otherwise, sometime waste of the time and energy will be there. Target strength need to be decided as good as what is written, FCK plus T into S. Then select the binder content that is earlier written. Then select activator by binder ratio, which is again norms are provided by FNARC or other things. I think other code is there. Then you can have the that ratio you select and find out the content of the activator. And after finding that, select the aggregate content, find dosage of the admixture. Then you conduct the trial mix, measured strength. If it is greater than target strength, then yes, you finalize the proposal. If no, then adjust the parameter. So I think this is the simple bar chart convey the meaning, which you can obey, then definitely you can have very good geopolymer concrete. Here, 2-3 papers are there, which is taken from standard journal. And then say one is geopolymer as an alternative to Portland cement. It is, I think I need not to read it. Similarly, second, review of recent development and advances in eco-friendly geopolymer. So inside it is given very good NaOH by Na to SO4 ratio they have selected. And then I think this is again very good paper, the development of flies-based geopolymer. I will skip it. Anything is there, but I will try to send to your organizer. Say here you can have very good visualized things. OPC is on right hand side, geopolymers on left hand side. Geopolymers a placement number 9, transport 9%, curing 40, something like that. Number is attached. CO2 is emission rate has been mentioned. So here OPC is concerned, placement, transport, curing, batching, admixture, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, and cement. But here you can find out sodium silicate, cement is zero, means left hand side no cement. Sodium silicate itself 156 proportion, and then sodium silicate, then sodium hydroxide also there, and fly ash is also there. So I think this is the directly visualize that here you are receiving 354 kg per meter cube, and here it is 320, and again it gives the good. So this is from literature, and it is very good way to understand the property, or about the geopolymer and OPC nature or composition. So this I will skip because you do not have time. But this last thing wanted to say, suppose you want to work, then proposed work can be narrated like this. Development of, suppose I earlier told feldspar geopolymer concrete, enhancement using nano additives, and then carbon footprint analysis with the help of available techniques, stress analysis, rigid pavement considering enhancement concrete property. And I think this is the again 3-4 point I have written, and I think this is not that much I wanted to say. And everything is there, then we have to perform SWOT analysis. S stand for weakness, which lack of practice, evidence, unskilled workmanship. Then, S means strength. Eco-friendly, alternate option, better performance. W is weakness. And then O means opportunity, it means sustainability. And threats means market adaptability. So I think this what you have to, we have discussed a lot about the things. Even I received one email from your Dr. Damayanti, and then it was asked some questions. So that also I try to overcome and at my level best. So here first question was there, due to COVID, what challenges civil engineer are facing, how to overcome it? So I think it is again very good questions and pertaining to our today workshop. So due to COVID pandemic, that is my, I mean, try to, you know, give convince to you or that query. Due to COVID pandemic, civil engineers faced number of problems such as they cannot execute the work in time, right? Because of lockdown, due to the constraint imposed by even state and central government, even in your area, nothing is there, but bylaws is imposed by, you know, state and central government and local bodies, panchayat or even SMC, then you cannot. Shortage of labor, because of it become how in such a way that labor are very not available, non-availability of ready-made material also, and not able to do testing so far as, because everything is there, then as per bylaws of the CPWD or PWD, that testing should be performed, but in that case laboratory is not available or not, you can say, working. So I think this is what is facing the problem, but up to now overcome the it, what is my suggestion, that up to certain extent we can utilize the time. Now other way we think positive, can utilize the time for other related activities such as planning. Suppose your project is, second project is there, and any project, then you plan in such a way that that work you are doing in a lockdown, designing, drafting, having interaction virtually with experts. Sometime while designing you will have problem, if site is there you can ask to take visit, but here prior to that you can have the your ready-made design drawing, so then you can virtually interact with expert, updating current trend and latest technology, evolving the construction sector. So I think this is just sort of thing I try to answer that first question. Second also, there is there any opportunity for civil opportunity for researcher to build the strong career through, you know, civil engineer in field of concrete? So I must say, as a because of I am, you know, because of professor I am telling, not like because of in academic I am not telling, but certainly by virtue of experience I can say yes, research in civil engineering, plenty of scope for high strength concrete, even HPC we have talked, behavior for long duration nobody has done, simply tested 28 days or maybe more than that, but till long term duration and you know performance not checked, even different exposure or still not clear. If you look at our infrastructure, most of the structures are concrete structure only, that's why infrastructure or construction industry is also booming for the past few years or few decades, you can say. This is the second question answer I am trying to give. Again, I mean long-term durability and other microstructure study is again, and as an engineer I think very good scope. Because I told that you will be better structural designer unless and until you do not know the about the behavior of the material, it is lacking. So that's why material behavior very well known prior to start the any consultancy as a structural consultant. Now, which are the challenges in research field of civil engineer? That was the question. So like any other field, civil engineering also having number of challenges. Particularly, we are facing shortage of good quality construction material due to booming of infrastructure, because of it is a very fast infrastructure is going on. So everybody are selling, and sometimes good quality material is not available. As we aware about 1 ton cement production lead to 1 ton of CO2 emission, which affect global warming, that you know. So that is why we have to explore new alternative and sustainable material. And this is one challenge. Apart from that, if you look at the monument, they are long lasting, more than 1,000 years without even having aircraft. And today you can say our building hardly 25 year or 30 year, and otherwise we are, and then we are getting, you know, notorious. So I think we have very good scope for research, and I think one very good topic known as climate change. So with respect to climate change, we have our industry also need to change our thought, and our to cater that need, we have to design and we have to accept sustainability material. And last one is, I think, five question is there. Fourth question, can we contact this expert for our industry or research related to problem? So you are always welcome, and it's my great pleasure and privilege to share my knowledge and expertise with you guys. We have been involving these kind of activities with various government, private agency and organization. So I think this small, simple one sentence I have written, and but still you are most welcome. My email ID and other thing is available with organizer. And the last one is how COVID affected field of civil engineer, mainly for site, this directly dealing with the concrete. So it is a similar answer what I have narrated in question one answer. It is more or less same, and something should be added. But I think with this, what I know little, I have presented. And thank you very much for giving me an opportunity and presenting you, I mean, on this platform. Thank you. Now, it is your turn to say raise query, and now it is time exactly 12:15.
Yes, sir, thank you so much. That no doubt we are many academicians completed our doctorate, and we are many industry person having with us, having more than many years of experience. But because of your speech and content, so many things are very clear in our mind. So we can guide and motivate our students too, and we can also interact with industry person whenever they require any solution based on, sir, your experience and presentation. Sir, whatever participants ask us question during registration, that we already asked. But one more question come from Prakash Chadhav, sir. That, sir, what is a quasi-ductile? That one question only came in chat box.
Correct. Quasi-ductile, sir. Chat box. Let me read. Neutron gestion, if you have any query, okay. Prakash, what is a quasi-ductile? Yeah. Very good questions. Ductile. A quasi-ductile is again just in between, not pure ductile, not pure brittle, intermediate state known as quasi-ductile, right? I think if you read M.Tech, suppose in any case, or one, you know, quasi word is there, or behavioral, ductile behavior is there, quasi, what is called, earthquake point of view. That is that word you could have heard, but if not, but I am clearing that it is a intermediate, not pure ductile and not pure brittle. So intermediate state, known as quasi ductile, right?
Yes, sir. During sir, when I was,
have heard.
Yes, sir. Sir, when I was in a master and you are taking our experimental stress analysis lecture, at that time, sir, you conveyed that quasi ductile material like gradually decay of tensile stress, right? Due to strain softening, without slightly improved tensile strength beyond first cracking strength. Such type of knowledge we have, sir.
Yes,
sir. So, sir, again, thank you very much from the end of Civil Engineering Department, S.N. Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, that you accept our invitation in that much short span and also given your precise time to our participants. Thank you very much, sir.
For your kind information, I am again attending one online agile. Chairman of one of the examination M.Tech.
Yes, sir. I know your busy schedule.
I manage and I requested to authority also. So it is permitted.
Yes, sir. I came to know from SVNIT only that sir is busy in that day for exam. but I request to please share time.
No, thank you. I enjoy. I am really thankful to all and specifically you. And thank you very much. Now you perform your formality because in between I interrupted. So you
and sir, this is one a great and pleasure thing that many participants from GACL and BCC, these are joined because of the your.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
NBCC now is really working well. Good.
Yes, sir. And GACL people, Suro industry people, many industry people, sir, join, and they also shown very good support to this program. Many industry people join, and we can say that 50-50 participants from industry and academia, and they join session and give very nice personal comment in our personal WhatsApp group, sir. So thank you so much again, and we will seek your support in the future events too. So. Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Now I would like to all participants kindly please join at 1:30. There is a lunch break from 12:15 to 1:15, and next lecture will start sharp at 1:30 p.m. So kindly please join on time. Thank you all. Thank you, sir.
I am leaving. Okay. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.